5 panelists, 5 topical issues, no holds barred.
For me, it's not knowledge that's lacking. It's that greed, it's that mentality where you feel you deserve to take your own and take it infinitely and let everybody else just manage however they will manage.
We're almost becoming hardwired to try and cheat. I would, you know, suggest that we begin to hold our leaders accountable.
There was a time in this country when things actually work.
I don't think that any organization should be above the law. And I think one of the challenges we have in this country is about governance across the board.
Well, what I'm saying is that it doesn't really affect us in Nigeria.
I don't know what we can do if the system is already corrupted.
We've been warned as a continent of the influx of the Chinese. If you don't repay your debt, they will just colonize you.
Well, Libras, some might say there's always room for acceleration. I'll be asking, when the going gets tough, do the tough really start digging into technicalities? COVID-19, is technicalities a major concern? Well, it all talks about the COVID-19 pandemic, and since its outbreak across all continents of the world, the possible catastrophic effects it could have on Nigeria, and indeed the rest of the world, remains a major cause of great concern. Considering the sophistication of the health systems and governance in Europe and America, vis-a-vis their current struggle to tackle the cases and death tolls, which has remained overwhelmingly high, there is no gain stating the obvious that Nigeria isn't prepared for a pandemic of this great magnitude. I'm not here to condemn the government at this time. As the saying goes, whenever you wake up is your morning. President Buhari and his advisers seem to have woken up last Sunday when he ordered a total lockdown of movement in the Federal Capital Territory, Lagos and Ogun states. I, however, do find intriguing the fact that a few legal minds have come up to challenge the constitutionality of the president's order. Not because they are wrong to challenge such, but because isn't the law or the executive order, as the case may be, all in the overriding interest of the citizens, which the same constitution seeks to protect? It was Walter Savage Landor, an English writer and poet, who philosophized many years back that when law becomes a science and system, it ceases to be justice. I like to think that those set of Nigerians challenging the constitutionality have not fully come to terms with the sort of biological war we are up against. It is a war where weapons of the written law conceivably cannot save the victims, whether wealthy or poor. Take it or not, Africa was given a head start. Nigerians, we had ample warnings, yet failed to act when there was still time for considerations. Borders were still open to travelers from high-risk countries. Our slow response has led us to where we are, where we currently are. Now we call it the fire brigade approach. The battle line has since been drawn. It's left for the authorities to fight in the best interest of us all. It's safe to say that the government alone can't do this. Stay home is a simple instruction. And while we battle to win against a deadly pandemic, our law enforcement agents, please do us the honor and do the nation some good by helping courts reduce the number of human rights actions it will need to hear when all this is over. Until then, I advocate on your behalf. Play your part. Please stay home, practice precautions, and stay safe.
Well said. Well said.
Sandra, I agree with you. Like they say, whether you want to obey President Buhari's
lockdown
order, or you want to obey the constitutional law, challenge of not staying at home because they say the order is not constitutional. It's left to you. If you catch the virus, make the lawyer to apply constitutional vaccine. It's that simple. Yeah, I agree with you also that this is not the time for legal technicalities. I have had cause to argue with some of these my colleagues who are my friends. Oh, the president doesn't have the power to do this. I also see where they are coming from against the backdrop of the precedent we have in government, where you allow government to have a free ride, you know, before you know it,
it becomes abusive.
Mm.
And also,
it becomes a precedent. But this is not the time for us to be discussing whether they were abused or not. Now is it stay at home. Whether the president had the power or not, will it solve the situation? If it will solve, stay at home. If you cannot stay at home, be careful. Just mind the distance and help government contribute to the fight. This is not the time to begin to argue, I want to go to court.
Mm.
And I also agree with you, these law enforcement agents should help reduce the human rights abuses. Some people do not understand. I've seen some people who say, look, even if they tell me this person has a virus, I won't hug him, he won't do me anything. Illiteracy in Nigeria is more than a disease.
Yeah.
So the law enforcement agent should help encourage and educate these people. This is not the time to begin to use the boot and the gun, including killing persons, because I was ashamed to listen to Governor Mahi of Ebonyi State saying if people refuse, you fire, shoot aside.
Wow.
This is not the time to begin to issue such order. This is the time to win all over, to understand, especially since we don't even have the facilities to tackle the pandemic.
Well, again, just taking up from the last, well said, Libros, well said, Sandra, I second and third it. You know, just taking up from Libros's advocacy as well, this is the time for responsible leadership.
True.
You know, whether these lawyers who are busy fighting their own corner, a lot of times you see people's hearts. They think that they're fooling you, but you see their hearts by the things they prioritize. People are dying the world over, even if they're not going to die of coronavirus. There's Lassa fever. There's enough going on in the world that tells you that this is time to pull together, not to be mischievous and try and show that you know book better than all of us. You know, we're not the first to want to trust the government with any legal instruments, even whether it's hate speech or even the generator. But we don't trust them. We agree. But at this point, even a blind man can see that. It has been proven that if you keep away from people with this virus, you slow down the pace of transmission,
right,
and you give yourself a chance. Since we, Libros even said in the preceding advocacy that we don't even have the facilities to deal with it, were it to spread at the rate it's spreading in Italy or Spain or even the UK, you know, where you're seeing deaths in the thousands, I think 8,000 at the last count in Italy. You know, so do we really want that on our conscience? So what are you really fighting for? You know, it's like, so you're fighting for a pin and then you lose the whole world. So let's just deal with the matter at hand now. Let the president then try and abuse it. We'll be right behind you saying, no, you don't, you know.
Even when, most especially when you have a president that hardly talks to you. Nah, he don't talk to you. You know, whether he's prepared speech or whether he's
no, Liberals, speech, when you have a president that if he wants to talk to you, he will first travel somewhere before he talk to you. But now, he day house, he talk to you.
Some people why say can't you, recorded.
Whether recorded or telecasted or whatever.
But take this simple.
He has spoken in a way you will understand.
Instruction.
Yes.
Whether he took questions and refused to answer.
Answer.
After all, listen to Sowolu is taking question and answer. If you know, so for me, it is not a question of
trying to prove points.
They're trying to prove
score
points. No. And mind you, these people that are telling you, oh, the president does not have the power, they're at home. Oh,
of course.
True.
No, you their children are at home.
Immediately I read that thing, my contribution, I just replied on was Instagram or Twitter. Mm-hmm. I said, you know what? You can show us all the legal intelligence you have now.
My brother, are they at the house?
No, we are not arguing with you. I just advise them, you know what? This COVID-19 will soon go. After
it goes.
After it has gone, you can see court. In fact, you. In fact, carry me and they can follow nobody. We go follow you, go
my
court.
My own response was this.
My friend called me.
We follow you to the court and we will stand by you. Yes, President, you were wrong. That time you made that statement.
Overtaken by events.
One of them called me and said, look, Libros, did you see this? I said, my guy, what is on my mind now is not whether it's legal or illegal. He said, no, as a lawyer, you should be concerned. I said, yes, I'm concerned. That's why I'm at home.
Exactly.
So I am concerned. I'm at home. Are you at home? He said, he's at home. Are your family at home? He said, yes. I said, okay, that is all that matters to me now. I don't want constitutionality. I don't want to argue constitution now.
Mm.
You're at home, I'm at home. Leave it there.
Yeah.
COVID-19 is enough constitutional to debate on now.
Yes,
true.
I'm telling you. So wisdom demands that everybody just
do what they know to be right.
Now.
Yeah.
For now. It will soon be over.
Yes. Well, it will soon be over.
We hope it will soon be over. I hope also that we're able to tackle the issue of, the ignorance.
Yes. yes.
That behoves around citizens.
That is if national orientation gets in.
Yeah,
if
we need, this is where we need those national
days,
orientation.
Those days,
if they'll behave like Mamsa.
Look, let me tell you. It's not enough. It's not enough. Because there is a larger percentage who are not.
Sandra, there are people. Those days,
it's
growing
good,
up,
not online.
Growing
social
up, environmental sanitation, you hear, Mamsa,
Mamsa,
national orientation, they all let Yamayama spoil your life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but now, they you hardly hear anything from National Orientation Agency. But I also must give kudos to my friend and brother, the DG, Delta State Orientation Agency.
I like the way
Barrister
you're calling out
Eugene
some positive
Uzum.
Examples.
That guy consistently, every day, he's everywhere around Delta giving information.
This is it.
And I told him, I said, look, if we have half of the what do you call it, the National Orientation Agency doing half of
what
you're
doing,
information will be everywhere. Not everybody telling
right
you
thing.
Drink this, do that, don't do this, don't do that. You know, we have not. For me, I feel bad when I see the Federal Minister of Health and the Center for Disease Control counting deaths
counting
and numbers for us. It's sad, really.
Well, you can't say we didn't sound the alarm on this edition. Let's ensure we each do our bit so that collectively we give ourselves a chance at survival. We're all in this together.
Mm-hmm.
Do keep your comments coming in on Facebook, Plus TV Africa, hashtag the Advocate NG, or on Twitter and Instagram at Plus TV Africa, hashtag the Advocate NG. To catch up with previous broadcasts, go to plustvafrica.com/theadvocate. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Plus TV Africa. Together, let's keep advocating for a better society. Until next time, bye.
Bye-bye.
Five panelists, five topical issues, no holds barred.
For me, it's not knowledge that's lacking. It's that greed, it's that mentality where you feel you deserve to take your own and take it infinitely and let everybody else just manage however they will manage.
We're almost becoming hardwired to try and cheat. I would, suggest that we begin to hold our leaders accountable.
There was a time in this country when things actually worked.
I don't think that any organization should be above the law. And I think one of the challenges we have in this country is about governance across the board.
What I'm saying is that it doesn't really affect us in Nigeria.
I don't know what we can do if the system is already corrupted.
We've been warned as a continent of the influx of the Chinese. If you don't repay your debt, they will just colonize you.
Step it up, Sandra.
Sure.
Yes, my that's my babe. I'm going to add that one on. That is the governor of Lagos State and his deputy were having sleepless nights, jumping between their offices, isolation centers, and media briefing. Twale to you, Baba. The governor of my adopted state, Abia, was relaxed and telling us that the virus will get to Abia because Abia was mentioned in the Bible. Maybe you don't know where room they. This guy don't laugh, he's my advocacy. Let me.